Morning all, me again. A cold and wet Tuesday morning. About 2 degrees at the minute. We're getting sleet and snow. But listen, let me tell you, it makes it all the more easier getting these boots on in the morning for these training walks, when I get really nice messages and donations that I've just read this morning from fellow YouTubers. So, for those that have donated me, I really thank you. Thanks for your support. And like I said, it makes it a damn sight easier getting these boots on in the morning, especially on wet, cold days like these. Yeah, so I'm doing a 14 miler this morning. Today. I'm not that fast. Up the Oxford Canal. So it should be good. Hoping to get my fire and ice video done as well, as it's below freezing. Hopefully it'll be okay for me to just dip my hands in the canal for a few minutes. Right, I'll catch you on the towpath, fellas. See you later. Hold on to your bellies. Going over a bridge. Right, I don't know if you can see for my fire and ice challenge. The canal is frozen with ice on. Strange, this half is, but that half isn't. So I'm on the canal towpath. Next time I'm on this, what I'm doing, I'm walking about, I think it's about 8. I'm doing about 14 miles today, so yeah, roughly 7 miles up to a little village called Cropperty. And then looping back round cross country, back round to where I park the car at the pub. So the next time I walk on this path, we'll be going that way, and we'll have walked about 96 miles, 95 miles. So yeah, pace will probably be a bit slower. I'm sure spirits will be high. It's a cold, frosty morning. Stop rain, stop sleeting now. We're sleeting early. Oh no, can't feel it, but you can see it on the canal. The canal is frozen in places, so I'm going to do my fire and ice challenge for Wild Ginger Bruce's 700 sub giveaway. I was nominated by Dale Skidmore, thank you, and so I'll be doing that later, and nominating two other YouTubers. I think we've got till the 19th of May, so yeah, got to get it done and then give the people I nominate, gives them a chance to get out and give it a go. Yeah, as you can see, there is, I don't know if you can see it on here, there is ice on the canal. I think most people have been doing it with buckets of water with ice in. That has a mouth for this walk, and I'm by the waterside and it's freezing, I might as well stick my hands in that. Whew. Right, I'm going to plod on. Just about to cross the canal. Get these wet weather gear off under there, I think. It's only spitting a bit now. I'm also out on a sort of recce today because we'll be around this sort of area on our last night, so I'm looking for spots we can potentially camp at. And I think our third day is 29 miles, which will be roughly around this sort of area, so I'm scouting for any, we're all hammock camping. So I'm scouting for any suitable spots for us to use on that last night. Here's a little spot here, look. Someone's already had a fire. Big believer in leave no trace, as you can see. Probably a farm burning these, clearing this area up here. Put that in a bad little spot in there, look. Get four hammocks in there easy. So there are options. Let's get back down this slope. We're only a stone's throw from the water's edge. So even in a little spot like this, and you're on your chin strap at the end of the day, anywhere to sling your hammock. And we're right on the towpath, look. So it's pretty good so far. Seen quite a few little spots. So lads, if you watch this video, the 100 mile crew, there's a few little spots I've seen. So I think we'll be alright for the last night. Ooh, I think this bridge is where I paddled to one day, one of my other videos. And I'm sure there's a lake over to the left and some wood, so I'm going to recce that. Yeah, it is. I sat down there and had a coffee, I think, and tied the boat up here. It's on one of my other vids. Have a look. There's the lake. All looks a bit marshy over there. Right, so here goes for my fire and ice challenge. I'm going to be doing flint and steel, ferrous sealing rod, matches and lighter. Got my cotton wool buds in there. Here's the freezing cold water. As you've seen, there is a bit of ice on it. So I'm going to crack on and do this. Right, here we go. In for a minute. I'm going to try the flint and steel first. I've already had a go, but I was struggling to get the ember to light the cotton wool. So I'm going to see if I can get the ember to light some jute twine, and then the jute twine to light the cotton wool, because I believe that's part of the challenge, cotton wool to light. Right, one, two, three. Right. Epic fail. Epic fail of the fire and ice challenge. Just could not get the flint and steel to ignite the cotton wool. So I've got the ember on the char cloth, but I couldn't get it to light the cotton wool, so I didn't even bother with the other three because gouged them. Happy finger using the flint and steel. The flint I bought was crap, so I smashed that, fished a new edge on it. Yeah, just couldn't light the cotton wool. Then I had some jute twine with me, so I made a bird's nest with that, tried to light that. It wasn't happening, so epic fail, fire and ice challenge. So I'll have to have another go some other time, but time's running out, isn't it? Gutted, don't like failing. I bet I spent about 45 minutes trying to do it. I did it at the end. Well, I'll probably put a little bit of the video on it. So yeah, just to show you how it's not easy. Good ball of tinder there, look. Put that in your pouch, wouldn't you, if you was out surviving? Yeah, so I might put a little bit on the video. Cheers, mate. So yeah, we'll crack on. Glad I bought these with me. That water was bloody cold. There we go. I think this is the spot that we'll use. Mind you, as I was doing that fire and ice challenge, a fella did approach me. Thought I was fishing. Thought I was mad as well. Yeah, a good little spot here, look, for our last night. What do you reckon, boys? Lovely little spot. Yeah, I reckon that's the one. That's the one we'll use. Spinning round so fast you can hardly see it. And why on here does it look like it's only going really slow? Old boatyard here, look. Under the camper. Dodgy looking characters over there, look. Wonder what they're saying about me. Yeah, this bad boy, look. This one's seen better days, look. And that one's taking a bit of water. Right, let's have a spot of lunch. Well, this nice little lock. Actually using one of these benches that I've been cursing all training walks. me noodles undergoing that one. Got me meatballs in that one. So yeah, a little bit of lunch. Peaceful. Just passed lots of barges down there. And they obviously live on them. They're not, I don't think they're fit for going up and down the canal, looking at the status of some of them. But then they've got these little pieces of land like this that they must own, or I don't know. Yeah, and they've set up little eating areas, and see a bit of bushcraft has been going on. It's pretty cool. Nice way of life, I should imagine. Something I would like to do if I was on my own. Right, let me get this scran down my neck and carry on when we walk. I'll see you later. Right, that's me leaving the towpath now. I'm winding my way through the countryside. Sure it's this way. Back to the car. That's the thing with towpaths. Might have been a bit slippy, but there's no hills. As soon as you get out on the road, you start getting the hills, don't you? They all seem to be going up them. Yeah, thanks for my donations. Got a couple of donations from fellow YouTubers. Basher Dweller, thanks very much. And Jay from Goonie Bushcraft. Very much appreciated. Like I said earlier when I was in the car, it makes it a lot easier putting the boots on in the morning on shitty mornings like it was this morning. When you get nice messages and donations. Ooh. It's going to such a good such a good cause. Yeah, really appreciate it. Thanks, lads. I'm full up now. I'll be sick of noodles and meatballs by the time we do this walk. Whew, right. Plod on. Treated the old boots yesterday. Some new cushioned insoles. You can see them, and some new laces. Treated the old girls. Done some miles in these. Done the Three Peaks Challenge in these. Plus all the training for it. Then a 90 miler plus the training. Mind you, I didn't train for that and it was hard. I've done a 100 miler before. All the trailing I've done for this one. And then the 100 miler coming up. I think I'm going to hang them up after that. these 42 year old legs starting to ache a bit. But you're never too old, are you? If I hang these up, do I get a new pair? Probably. Right, that's me nearly done. Well, this road section's been a bit grim. Preferred walking on the taper. Oh, right, so I'm just going to drop down now underneath the road and follow canal about 400 metres back to the car. So again, thanks for watching, commenting and subscribing. And if you'd like to sponsor me, the link to my Just Giving page will be in the description below. Whew, see you on the next one, folks.